So hello, I'm back. My name is Lita. This is Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines, and I was about to talk with the good prince about the fact that I got the sarcophagus to him. So, hi there.
My Wunderkind returns.
Yeah.
In my entire court, I knew there was only one who could have succeeded in this task.
Me!
Finally, the Ankoran sarcophagus is ours. Mm-hmm. Some. I've granted Beckett's request to study and document all the markings of the sarcophagus. You've met Beckett, haven't you?
Yeah.
Let's go take a look inside and see what the commotion around the city has really been all about.
Okay. I can't wait. Actually, I shouldn't open it, but... Okay. Oh, I can say something interesting. I know. Prince Lacroix and Ming Zhao sitting in a tree. Plotting.
What? Preposterous. No kindred would trust them, nor would they trust us. Did Jack tell you that? Because
no.
It sounds like you've been taken for a fool.
I've been taken for a ride.
And you believed them? They've been trying to take over L.A. for years. It's a ruse, a falsehood, spread to undermine my rule and turn kindred against each other, thin our ranks. They are duplicitous, evil creatures. Did they not try to kill you?
Yes. Lots of people have.
Insurance. They lied to you in case you lived through the encounter. They hoped to create dissension in the ranks, rumors. It's a trick older than you or I.
Paranoia again. Let's open the box.
What have you assessed so far?
Unfortunately for the Heralds of Doom, it appears we won't be opening Pandora's box. The markings, as far as I can tell, are of Assyrian origin. An extraordinary piece, but nothing earth-shattering.
I see. Then there is no good reason why we shouldn't open it. In it.
Sorry about that. The game just acted Beckett. Up.
Do you see any mechanism for the lid?
I haven't as yet had a chance to pore over it with my fine-tooth comb. I think I have one in my bag.
Why won't it open, Beckett? And you? I thought you said it looked as if it had been opened on the day.
Yeah.
I want it open! You and Beckett, figure out a way to open it. I need to know what's inside. I have other matters to attend to. Come get me when a solution has been found.
Okay, next
step. Ah, the depths to which I'll sink to prove others wrong. The young ones get so temperamental. Fortunately for Sebastian, is it?
Yeah.
I'd already made up my mind to open the sarcophagus, if only to show the city that Gehenna, contrary to popular belief, has not begun.
Awesome. So, how does it open? Actually... yeah.
In the last few seconds, I've had very few epiphanies. I may be old, but I didn't build it. How knowledgeable are you on ancient Assyrian funerary constructs?
Depends. If you give me the right books, I will be an expert in no time. I saw words, but no, not one I knew passed by.
Yes, quite astute. Fortunately for us, I know of someone who has distinguished himself mm-hmm. in this field.
I knew that he would be useful. That guy on the historical network with the piss helmet? He makes learning really fun.
No. His name is Dr. Ingvar Johansson, a professor of archaeology from Norway.
Mm-hmm.
He was the one responsible for finding the sarcophagus, and as far as I know, the only authority on its origin and design.
And is he in the bathroom? You can always find mortals in there.
Until yesterday, he could have been found in his suite at the Empire Hotel downtown. But when I stopped by earlier this evening, all I found was spilt coffee on a morning paper. Appears he's been abducted.
Damn aliens, that's who did it, right?
I detected the scent of myrrh incense, which is usually burned in monasteries.
Mm-hmm.
Also, I found beach sand and part of a muddy footprint. Putting two and two together, I located a monastery near a beach in Malibu, where I believe hunters are holding Johansson captive. Actually, there were two hunters on the roof of the building opposite the hotel who were positively delighted to tell me everything they knew.
I see.
Provided I stopped dangling them head first over the side.
So, what hunters, where, who, why, and which?
The hunters abducted Dr. Johansson for his own protection. Or at least that's how they've justified it. He's being held by the Society of Leopold and used, quite ingeniously, as bait for Prince LaCroix's minions.
Leopold is a good name for a turtle.
Sebastian mentioned you ran into one of the hunters from the Society of Leopold some time ago.
Yes, I did.
They're so secret a church organization. I don't even think they know if they exist. But essentially, they're murderers for Christ, or some such deity.
All right, I am a fish. Where's the hook?
You'll have to go to the monastery and find a way into the tunnels beneath, where the hunters are holding Johansson.
Uh-huh.
I'm afraid I can't accompany you. Then it's best you go alone. Too many of us might set them off. Like fundamentalists on contrary opinion.
Can I borrow your airship?
I wouldn't recommend walking. Certainly, Sebastian's already provided cab fare. I'm sure he always spares no expense when archaeology is at stake.
I want something from your brain.
Excellent.
Tell me more of this mysterious Leopold character.
The society, for the most part, knows very little about us. But they do know how to kill and torture us, and that's enough. Also, some of them exhibit powers that can make them quite formidable. Obfuscate will serve you well around the hunters.
Is the box Pandora's?
Well, if we open it up and the world ends, then yes. If we open it up and the world does not end, then no. I'd wager the latter.
If I was a mirror, who is that person you're staring at?
I've said quite a lot about myself already.
Tell me more.
I know even less about you than you do me. Why don't you tell me about yourself?
Okay, now what? I devour knowledge like the great worm devours the corpse of society.
I consider myself a seeker of reluctant information. Scholar sounds like academia. Ugh. How versed are you in the occult? Then you wouldn't know that Dracula, the fictional vampire of movie fame, was very real. His real name was Vlad Tepes, and he was a Jemisi, though he was not savant. By some accounts, he still lives into these nights. Unless you've got further questions, I'd really like to get back to looking at the sarcophagus.
Okay, this is all I wanted of him. My head is full of nothing right now. I'm gone.
Remember, Dr. Johansson is an innocent. He has no idea we actually exist. Try not to put the idea in his head.
I'll try. What idea, actually? So, stats were increased just now, and this means, he increased my scholarship to the maximum amount, and I could increase my intelligence. Then I have a research skill of 9. This means that I can read books. Increasing my computer skill. Increasing... those are useless books. There is one melee book, there is a finance book, there is another melee book, and there is a dodge book. Yeah, dodge is nice because it increases the defense. But melee? I could do that. But I don't intend to use melee weapons at all. So maybe I should just sell these books. Dude.
Did you find a way to open the sarcophagus?
The sarcophagus is secure. I wish my finances were similar.
I can't have my protege looking plebeian, can I?
Yeah.
You'll find I can be very generous towards those who serve me well.
I fought beasts beyond imagination. I coated myself in the filth of kine.
Point made.
700 bucks. Yes. I am an unstoppable hydra now. Okay, I am going to do the Ashes quest now.